Good evening, America. Again, my name is Marcus Smith, and I'm before you tonight to share part two of my idea for economic improvement. This particular video will focus upon the innovation in employment, how employment can adapt to a system that is able to sufficiently fund it. In my previous video, I covered exactly how an independent funding system, solely for the sake of supporting employment, could be created. What would be its regulations, and why would it be necessary? In this particular video, I have two questions I'm going to focus upon. What can and will be done to improve the system of employment? How would the income of specialized careers and emergency responders be affected? And my closing statement will focus upon why I advocate this particular idea. Now, my first question: what can and will be done to improve the system of employment? When we genuinely accept a system that is able to sufficiently fund employment, then we must ask ourselves, what is the best way to orient the system of employment? What is the best way to continue our practices of it so that homelessness and unemployment become obsolete ideals? I believe that the best means to improve our practice of employment would be to change the way we look at how individuals earn their income. I believe that we should remove the concept of an hourly ratio. The reason why I say this is because currently, the amount of individuals that need employment is 315 million. Of course, over time, this number is going to grow as our population grows by approximately 2 to 4 million every 2 years. If we want to eliminate homelessness, eliminate unemployment, then we have to be able to ensure that there are genuinely enough jobs for everyone. At the same time, we also have to take into consideration the fact that in an hourly sense of income, individuals would be losing income if they were to reduce in the amount of hours that they have to work. The only way to have the best of both worlds, ensure that individuals are still able to meet their income needs, as well as at the same time, ensure that we are able to supply individuals with jobs when that is necessary. In removing the hourly ratio of work, we would solely be replacing it with work shifts. By this I mean that if an individual's shift, and the base that I have for this idea is 3 to 5 days per week, 4 to 6 hours per day. Reason why these intervals are different for each is because the minimum amount of time that I believe an individual should work is 4 hours per day, 3 days per week. This would ensure a society that needs to supply jobs, it needs positions in its market. The maximum amount of hours I believe an individual should work are 6 hours per day, 5 days per week. Of course, there will be some positions that require more, such as truck driving or emergency responders or those in the medical field. However, I believe that in each of these positions, we have to pay very close attention to time. We have to pay very close attention to one's emotional and mental stress in these situations, as well as the sheer fact that there are, of course, going to be bonuses pertaining to one's income when in these particular job fields. The second question: how would the income of specialized careers and emergency responders be affected? Of course, as society takes into consideration the fact that menial positions such as our garbage disposal individuals, our cashiers, our customer service individuals, call centers, any position that is considered menial, by these individuals being able to earn $60,000 per year. Individuals that earn drastically more than that, or $20,000 more than that, may feel a bit personal, to say the least. Of course, I believe that these individuals should have their income raised. Of course, I believe that even our doctors, who genuinely should work less simply because of the amount of mental strain and the fact that they genuinely have someone's lives in their hands at every moment of the day, I believe that even as it pertains to our emergency responders, we have to give ourselves relaxation. We have to genuinely offer our society the ability to relax one's mind, relax one's body, without infringing upon society itself. I believe that over time, we would not only improve ourselves, we would not only grow to be better people, but overall, we would genuinely see a better society. Simply because individuals would know that even if they are very close in earnings to another individual, it's the sheer fact that we are all able to meet the standard of living. We are all able to meet what it costs to be successful in society. This type of system would drastically reduce all negative aspects of our society. It would help us be able to manage ourselves as individuals. That, in and of itself, answers why I advocate this idea. Not only do I believe that it will create better citizens, but I believe that it will genuinely create a better society and an economic practice. Thank you for your time, and please ask any questions that you may have.